Denise Beelman won 4 professional events last year. She wins with a style that is all her own, you'll see what we mean, as she skates to Push It by Salt and Peppa.
Yo, her, take it from the top. 1, 2, are you ready?
I said it in her first program, I'm going to say it again. She was in great, great shape last year. I think she's in better shape this year. She is cut. See the muscle definition. She's skating with more speed this year than last year. Opening with triple toe loop. Whoa, that was tilted way outside and she still had the strength to pull it off. Triple style, she's got a lot of speed. She's gonna pick up some more. And look at the height and distance that she carries on this jump. Flexibility, this is her signature spin, a variation of her signature spin.
Let the beat control your body, let the beat control your body.
This is kind of wall-to-wall skating, isn't it?
Well, not only is she holding a technical clinic, she's also holding an aerobics class out here. It's hard to believe that she's the oldest woman in this event because she's putting a lot more energy into her performances than anybody else.
This will hardly qualify as a scoop. But when Denise Beelman finally decides to retire from competitive skating, she's going to run some fitness centers.
Height of these split jumps. And her specialty, after all that jumping, really is spinning. Look at this illusion into a sit spin. Into her Beelman spin. The scratch spin perfectly centered. Headless scratch spin. Well, it's an artistic competition, but this is quality skating. Big theater mother, Heidi Beelman. She delivered the goods. She's so tough to beat, and she's really put the pressure on Karen Kadavy.
As well as that quartet of skaters who qualified in Mankato to advance to Boston, including Oksana Bayul. Karen Kadavy takes to the ice. She'll be the last one to compete. We wait for the scores for Denise Beelman.
This triple toe loop was really tilted outside. And you got to remember, she's landing on her left foot, and she's tilted way out to the right, right there. There's almost no way you can land that. But she righted herself on the way down. It was beautiful. Look at the height, the air position, the distance across the ice. She was almost loose in the air. Look at the strength of landing position and her specialty. After all that great jumping, she goes right into the spinning. Good low sit spin there, and then she'll just reach back and say, this is what made me famous. A lot of centrifugal force and effort. She has to get that right arm around and grab the blade, and then she'll just pick that foot straight up. this just hurts looking at it, especially in slow motion. Mom, yeah, she knows. This is good. This is good. This is really good. I like this. This is fun. I like it when everything stays vertical and we spin a lot and we get the crowd going. This is fun. Okay. Marks are going to be good, too. Mom knows that. She's relaxed. She's going, yeah, five nines. Five nines, probably, yeah.
Well, Denise needs 57-1 to pull ahead of Kerrigan. I think that will not be a problem.
Yeah, five nines. We predicted those. No problem. Five nines. And again, the last thing you want to be as the leader in this competition, the next to skate, is hearing that you have to skate 6-0 to win. 1-5-7, the rest 5-9s, really puts the pressure on Karen Kadavy.
That total of 58-8 gives Denise Beelman a two-round total of 116.4. Katarina Vitt, Rory Flack-Burkhart, Nancy Kerrigan, and Yvonne Gomez follow. And if Karen Kadavy, who's the last to compete, passes Nancy Kerrigan,